So, hello everybody. I am Lucas, from the owner from Klipsun Project, and this is the first Zen Education podcast, which we are celebrating the launch from the Zenon Music Production Mark II. And we have a special guest from this first edition, which is the Zenon boss, I call it like that. Tim Larner, how are you, boss?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Yeah. Good to see you.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, it's a pleasure. And today we're going to talk a specific topic on this first podcast. And I think from the followers from Zenon Records is a very, very interesting topic, and especially from the artists like be part from Zenon in the future, no? And Zenon Education have is part of this because Zenon Education incentivate the Zenon sound around the world, you know. And the main topic of this conversation, which will be like, what is characteristic from a track or an artist to be part of Zenon, you know? And if you have some words about how is the main characteristics from music or artist to be part of Zenon, for start this conversation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's as always, putting music into words can be difficult, but I'm going to do my best. Yeah, it can be hard to describe musical things with words, but the first thing that comes to mind is originality. I'm really looking for music that's original. Mm-hmm. As people probably know, there's a lot of there's a big range of sounds in Zenon Records, you know, from the really dark progressive like hypergeo. Mm-hmm. To the daytime sounds like Earthiogen, for example. So there's a lot of space inside Zenon Records to make a new sound. And I actually, I'm looking for new sounds. So someone could send me music which is really, really nice and well-produced and really good, but if it sounds too much like hypergeo, then I'm not so interested, you know. Like, I want to hear a new style and a new sound. And I think there's still space, even after, you know, nearly 20 years of Zenon Records music, there's still space for new sounds, and it is still happening. I still am, new artists are coming to Zenon with a fresh sound that I didn't hear before. So that's really what I'm looking for on a more kind of broad mm-hmm. sense. But then obviously the more technical things, like the production quality should be high, and the musical content, the intelligence and the musical content in music, should be high as well, should be good. Yeah.
Yeah, it's interesting you say about you have a lot of artists sent to music to you, but sounding like hypergeo or something like chromagon, like, say, you know, because mm-hmm. Today is very, you have too much access to a lot of context in the internet, you know, how to producing like this artist, how to producing like mm-hmm. this artist, you know. Mm-hmm. This is very interesting because when I talk about the Zenon sound, for me is the originality is the word, you know. For me, mm-hmm. My personal, let's say, goal, is to push me, my music, to another originality, you know, or push me to another Zenon sound, you know, find another Zenon sound, because Zenon is a big spectrum. Huh? This is this is very interesting. You say like that, and in some technical things, when is the right time to send a track for you? You think like, let's say I am a new artist, and then I think to send a music to Zenon. When you think is the best time to send to you? You know, like. Is
6:30 p.m. in the evening. No, I'm joking. Very specific. 6:30.
But like an artist, let's say I have a one track finish, or I need to be to have a EP finish, or what is your thoughts about that?
Well, yeah, very important is that even if it's only one track, it should be finished. Because I don't have time to. Unfortunately, I don't have time to give feedback on tracks that are in progress or tracks that aren't finished. So, yeah, that's the number one thing that needs to be finished. And, yeah, preference would be like an EP, four tracks. More than one, you know, two or three or four is good. But even, you know, I'll listen to one track as long as it's finished. I'll still listen to it and one track is enough to, if someone's really good, got good music, one track is enough to hear something special. So yeah, even one is okay.
And two questions, let's say. You listen all the tracks you when you're receiving the email, or you make some, oh, maybe this artist I know, or what is your filter, let's say, you know, to listen the tracks?
Yeah. Usually I try and listen to everything that comes in, because my attitude is maybe I'll miss the gem, you know, if I say no, I'm not going to listen to that, and then who knows,
yeah,
it could be the next big thing, you know, so I try and at least give everything a listen. But yeah, I do get quite a lot of demos where I can tell that this person has sent the same demo to like 50 record labels at the same time.
Yeah.
I can kind of see that they're not really interested in Zenon or don't know much about Zenon. And so then I think, I don't think it's going to fit. So I'm less likely to listen to that or give time to that. So I guess sometimes I don't listen to ones like that if I can see that they've sent it to 50 labels at the time, and it's kind of like a generic message, and also what they write as well. I like to see someone write a message personalized about Zenon Records in the email with the demo. Yeah, when I see someone who tells a little story about how Zenon has affected them or what artists they like, or so I can see that this is like a message specially for Zenon Records and not for 50 other record labels. So they're the ones that I like take more notice of and make sure if I can see someone has a special connection with Zenon Records, then I'll always try to respond and always take the time to listen. Yeah,
that's a good advice actually for new artists, you know, because I see a lot of artists, like you say, send one track from 10 labels in the same time, you know, try to find a new release, let's say, you know, and Zenon have this particularity, you know, because it's the Zenon sounds is only in the Zenon Records, let's say, you know, and if you're producing and focus in Zenon, is only in Zenon you have to this focus. It's a good advice, yeah. And the best way to contact Zenon is for email or Facebook page. What do you prefer?
Probably the email, through the website, the contact form or the email there, yeah.
Yeah. And what is the best format to send to you? Is the track need to be mastering, or is a demo or SoundCloud link? What is the best format to you?
Mm-hmm. It doesn't need to be mastered. SoundCloud link is okay, but I usually like to download the track and hear it in full quality. So yeah, if it's on SoundCloud, downloadable will be good. I like to listen to them. I like to sort of close the computer and listen to them, you know, in a different space. So it's nice to download it and take it away somewhere and listen. Yeah.
And curiosity, how many hours you spend in your day to listen to tracks? Is a lot of tracks you receive per day, or yeah?
Yeah, I mean it's a lot of tracks. But I can tell pretty quickly whether something is up to like the Zenon Records level or not. So I don't need to listen to whole tracks, and I only listen to a whole track if it's really good and I need to like check it out in full detail. Because I have a lot of demos, so I don't have time to listen to every demo all the way through. Mm-hmm. So if a demo gets me to listen to a whole track, then it's a really good demo and it's doing well. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm. And let's say if I am an artist and then I send to you the track and you like my track, and then you send a message to me to release on Zenon, what is the next steps from an artist? Mm-hmm. Like when the track is choose, let's say, you know.
Yeah. Well, then I would ask the artist for the final pre-master, so with no master effects. And then you would get into details about agreements or how it's going to look with the release, or whether I want to sign this artist, you know, or whether it's just going to be a compilation release. That the main thing would be just to provide the final mix down, yeah, for the mastering engineer. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And the artwork and the distribution is all from is like what's happening this process too? Because mm-hmm. I receive a lot of questions about if an artist needs to master the track to release on Zenon, or where's this process?
Mm-hmm.
If you can tell us about more.
Yeah, well, Zenon takes care of the mastering. I have one or two mastering engineers that we work with. And the same thing with the artwork. Like if it's an EP, Zenon, I have a few artists that I work with. And if the musician has some ideas about the artwork, like specific ideas or concepts, then yeah, we're always open to bring those in, and they can always share those with the graphic designer. Mm-hmm. To get some art that they're happy with.
Because Zenon have a particular identity in the visuals.
So I'm very kind of careful with that, and I always will have like the final say on the artwork, and because mm-hmm. it really needs to fit the Zenon style. But in saying that, there's been times where some artists have bring their own, like that they'll say, oh, I really want to work with this artist, this graphic designer. Like the latest one was the Irie album that came out earlier this year, and he had a mm-hmm. designer from Japan that he really wanted to use, and it's something original and different, and not necessarily like Zenon style, but it's still really cool and still works. Yeah.
Yeah, it keeps the originality from the concept mm-hmm. of the Zenon, yeah.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Yeah, so for the last, I think the last, it's not a question, but is if you can send a message to all the Zenon followers and also the artists which can be part of Zenon in the future, and if you can send a message like from this the people who listen to us right now.
Thanks for all your support and your passion in following Zenon. It's been a crazy journey, an amazing musical evolution. And I hope some of you one day can be part of that process of evolution and the process of moving the Zenon sound forward and creating new branches on the Zenon tree. I'm sure some of you listening now will do that. So that's pretty cool and exciting. And I just hope you enjoy the process of listening to Zenon music and producing it, if that's what you're doing. Just remember to have fun with it as well. The process.
Yeah, so thank you for all the people who listen to us right now. Mm-hmm. So thanks, Tim, from your time. I'm pretty sure you are very busy. So thanks for this conversation. I think from a lot of artists is a precious information, let's say, from the artists looking to release on Zenon. Yeah. And I think we're gonna be a good content from everybody. So thank you for your time. And bye bye.
Yeah, no worries. Bye bye, everyone. See you later.